Starting December 8th, the look and feel of the Federal Service Desk self-service portal will be different. However, the web address will remain the same. You will continue accessing the website by typing fsd.gov into your browser. The Federal Service Desk portal provides a unified self-service experience to submit a service desk ticket through Create an Incident, live chat with a representative, or if you prefer to figure things out on your own, a unified knowledge base full of helpful articles that can assist in finding answers to commonly asked questions. It's a one-stop location to request help. So whether your issue is related to password reset, entity registration, or searching for opportunities, if you submit a ticket, it will be routed to the appropriate support team. Otherwise, you will be able to use the Federal Service Desk portal as a resource to quickly search for your answer. When accessing the FSD.gov self-service portal for the first time, look for a guided tour. This badge means one or more guided tours are available on this page. When you select a tour, call-outs take you through interactive steps to help you perform the selected task. This option allows you to view and perform limited actions to familiarize yourself with these different tools. Please be aware that during some tours, you will simply read the information pertaining to the steps you must take when you are ready to use that feature. Also, there's an accessible guide option where you can download the PDF version of the guided tours. FSD.gov is now using login.gov, offering two-factor authentication and stronger password requirements to secure its users' information. All users will need to create a login.gov account to access the new FSD.gov site. If you were previously registered with FSD.gov, you might want to use the same email address so that your historical ticket information is carried over to the new FSD.gov site. Anyone can register for an FSD.gov account. From the average person who wants to search the knowledge base to perform a task on their own without speaking to a live agent, to those who simply need to upload an electronic notarized letter to request an entity administrator be added to their SAM entity registration. Go to the FSD.gov homepage by typing FSD.gov in your internet address bar. Once you're there, click the sign in link located in the top right of the homepage. An option to accept the U.S. government system terms will be presented to you. In order to continue this process, click the Sign In button in that pop-up screen. You will be brought to the login.gov page, and this is where you will create your account. Click the Create an Account button. This is where you will provide the system information about yourself. Follow the prompts to complete this part of your registration and then be routed to the FSD.gov homepage. If you have an existing login.gov account from beta.sam.gov, sam.gov, ESRS, and fsrs.gov, or FPDS, you may access fsd.gov using that existing login information. Visit login.gov/help and click the Create an Account button if you require additional assistance. You may be asking yourself, where can I locate frequently asked questions or information for the system I use? Previously, you would have located that information here. Now you will use the search bar to explore the public knowledge base to answer any question you may have. Or if you see your question in our help topics, click on the link to navigate to all articles associated with that category. Live chat is a feature previously offered to you on the previous FSD.gov site. Now you can access that same feature here. You simply initiate chat by clicking this button on the home page, and a live agent will connect and either guide you to where you need to be on the self-service portal or provide you with an answer to your question. Let's take a live view of the live chat feature. To initiate a chat, simply click the live chat button. A window will appear and will ask you to type your question and hit enter. You will notice a welcome message from the agent who's been assigned to you. You may interact with the agent in the message box. To the right of the message box, if you need to upload a document, simply click the upload attachment icon. At the top of this chat window, you notice that I'm connected to that agent. And to the right of that, if I wanted to end the chat, I would click the red button that says end chat. To end the chat, I'm clicking end chat. If I wish to see my support conversation history, I click the left arrow. And now I can see my closed conversations by clicking on it. I can review all of my history concerning that particular conversation. And if I had more closed conversations, I can click on those and see those as well. I will simply close out my window, and I'm back on the homepage of FSC.gov. Previously, if you wanted to submit a question, you would select Web Form from the FSC.gov homepage. Now you will select Create an Incident, which allows you to submit a ticket, and it will be routed to the appropriate support group, and you will receive an answer to questions that you were unable to locate via the knowledge base or help topics. If you wish to view the status of an incident ticket, you will click My Incidents from the top navigation. From this list, you have the option to view all requests or can view one incident at a time. Stay tuned for future communications before the December 8th launch date. Need help now? Call 866-606-8220 or search for your answers on FSC.gov. Thank you.